There was once a little boy named Peter, and he lived in a small cottage near a great forest with his grandfather. Early one morning, Peter opened the garden gate and went into the forest to play with his friends. He had many friends in the forest. There was Robin Redbreast. And Quacky the Duck. And Tommy the Cat. Soon his grandfather came after him. He was annoyed because Peter had gone into the forest.
"I told you it was a dangerous place,"
he said to Peter when he found him.
"What if a wolf should come along? What would you do then?"
He took Peter by the hand, led him back to the garden, and closed the gate. No sooner had Peter gone than a great hungry wolf did appear in the forest. In a twinkling, Tommy the Cat scampered up a tree. Robin Redbreast flew to a branch above the cat. While Quacky the Duck, on seeing the wolf, quacked and quacked in her great excitement and started to run. But no matter how hard she ran, Quacky the Duck couldn't escape the wolf, and with one great gulp, he swallowed her. So this was how things stood. Tommy the Cat was on one branch, and Robin Redbreast was on another, not too close to the cat, mind you. And the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking up at both of them with greedy eyes. Peter saw what was happening to his little friends, and as he watched, the wolf paced back and forth. Suddenly, Peter thought of a plan. Not being at all afraid, he went into the house and found a strong rope. Then, when the wolf wasn't looking, Peter climbed up the tree, made a lasso, and carefully lowered it down. In no time at all, he'd caught the wolf by the tail, and he pulled with all his strength. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly and tried to free himself. Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree, and the wolf, twisting and turning, only made the rope tighter round his tail. In fact, the rope was so tight, the wolf cried out, and while his mouth was open, Quacky the Duck jumped out and was free again. Just then, shots were heard. Some hunters, who'd been following the wolf's trail, came out of the forest shooting as they walked. Peter shouted, "It's all right. I've already caught the wolf. Please help me take him to the zoo." And off they all went. There was Robin the Redbreast, Tommy the Cat, Quacky the Duck, Peter's grandfather, and the hunters carrying the wolf. Right out in front, though, was Peter, who marched proudly, for he alone had caught the wolf.